Hey guys, my name is Matt Johnson, and today I want to share with you how I shoot and edit video footage that is mixed frame rates. A lot of you have noticed in my wedding films and my drone videos that I shoot at a variety of frame rates, sometimes at 24 frames per second, sometimes 30 FPS, 60 FPS, even 120 FPS. And a lot of you have been asking me two questions. First, why do you shoot so many frame rates? And second, how do you edit all of those frame rates together in Adobe Premiere and make them look good? Well, today I'm excited to say that I'm gonna be sharing both of those answers with you. So let's open up Adobe Premiere. All right, welcome to Adobe Premiere Pro CC 2018. I'm gonna go up here to Help, About, and you can see that I'm on version 12.0.0. If you are on a different version, it should not matter because these settings and things I'm gonna be walking through apply to pretty much all the versions of Premiere that I've ever used. So don't stress about that. Now let's look over here in the project window, and as you can see, I have imported three video clips. One is at 23.976 frames per second, the other one is at 29.97 frames per second, and the last is at 59.94 frames per second. So 24, 30, and 60 FPS, if we're rounding up here like everybody does. Now I am a wedding filmmaker, and I shoot at a variety of frame rates throughout the wedding day. And as a rule, if I am filming anything that has audio in it, such as a groom reading a letter here, for example, or a wedding ceremony, or wedding toast, anything that has audio, I want to shoot it at 24 frames per second because that matches up with the frame rate of my timeline, which we will discuss in just a moment. Now, if I'm shooting anything that does not require audio to be synchronized to the video, such as groom prep here, for example, I want to shoot that at 30 frames per second. And I have two reasons for doing that. The first is that whenever you slow down 30 frames per second footage to 24 frames per second, it makes it look all dreamy and magical. The other reason that's also more important than that is that it also takes out any of the bumps and shakes and me getting my camera caught in my beard, which has happened before. By shooting at 30 frames per second, it makes things just a little bit smoother once you slow it down, and I'm a big fan of that. I need all the help that I can get in that area. Lastly, we have 60 frames per second footage here, which as you can see, this is the bride and groom together. And the reason that I want to shoot that at 60 frames per second is because it's a very big emotional moment and I want to drag that out as long as possible. So if they're staring at each other's eyes, I want them to stare at each other for a long time. And by shooting at 60 frames per second and being able to slow that down to 24 frames per second, it is going to make that stare long and it's going to look really, really pretty. Now that I've explained all that, it is now time for us to create a new timeline so we can edit these video clips. But we have an issue because if I scroll over here, you're going to see under video info that these first two clips are 3840 by 2160, 4K resolution. But this last clip is 1920 by 1080, 1080p. How are we going to create a sequence that works with both of these? Well, I have good news for you because I have created a video that covers how to edit videos that are multiple resolutions in one timeline. So I would highly recommend watching that. I will link to it up here in the corner and down in the description. But for the sake of brevity here in this tutorial, so I don't have to go through all that. All I'm going to do is I'm going to create a new sequence and I'm going to upscale my 1080p clips to 4K. Now let's make a timeline. I'm going to go up here to File, New Sequence, and that is going to open up the New Sequence dialog box, which is where we're going to tell Premiere the video frame rate and resolution that we want to be editing and exporting our video at. In this case, we're going to want to go to one of the sequence presets and we're going to select Red R3D. Even though I did not shoot this video on a Red, I shot it on an A7S II, that does not matter. What matters is that in these presets, there are settings that match up perfectly with the settings of the video that I shot. So we're going to click the little drop down here for Red R3D, and we're going to go down to HD 4K, and we're going to select 4K HD 16:9 23.976. Now this is the sequence that I'm going to be editing with, and I want you to pay attention to the frame rate here, 23.976 frames per second. Anytime that I shoot any video that has audio that I need to sync up with the lips of the person speaking, then I want to be shooting at 23.976 frames per second because I will not be making this footage slow motion. If you shoot at a higher frames per second and then try to make it slow motion, everybody's gonna be talking slow and it's not going to match up. So my recommendation to you is anytime you shoot anything where you require the audio to sync up, I recommend shooting at 23.976 frames per second. But you're telling me, Matt, I shot stuff at other frames per second. I shot stuff at 30 and 60 and 120. Do I still select 23.976? Yes, because all of that footage that you are going to be making slow motion at 30 FPS, 60 FPS, 120 FPS, on and on, we are going to be turning that into 23.976 frames per second footage later on in this tutorial. So with this preset selected, we are now ready to begin editing. So let's go down here to sequence name and we're gonna name this frame rate tutorial. Yeah, that sounds good. Let's hit OK. Next, let's go over here and start dragging some clips down to the timeline. First, I'm going to drag this clip that is 23.976 frames per second because that matches the timeline settings here perfectly. drag it down, no pop-ups at all. And man, look at that, that looks really great. Let's hit play. As you can see, it's playing smoothly. It's playing at the exact same frame rate as the timeline, so it matches perfectly. Let's shorten this clip down because it's really long, so we have room for other clips here. And let's drag down our 29.97 frames per second clip. So our 30 FPS clip. Drag it down here to the timeline, put it over, and we're gonna hit play. And as you can see, things look a little stuttery. It's not quite as smooth. And the reason for that is because we are dropping this 30 frames per second clip directly onto a 24 frames per second timeline. And whenever it does that, Premiere has to do a lot of background math to actually get rid of 6 frames every second, because it is trying to make this 30 frames per second clip 24 frames per second. Next, let's drag the 59.94 frames per second video clip onto the timeline here and hit play. And you're gonna see it actually looks really stuttery too, because Premiere is having to drop over half of the frames to make this work on a 24 frames per second timeline. It doesn't look bad, honestly, but it's not super smooth. It doesn't look nearly as smooth as the 4K footage here at 24 frames per second. That stuff, smooth as butter, I love it. There isn't really any way that you can make 30 or 60 frames per second footage playback smoothly on a 24 frames per second timeline unless you make the clip slow motion. This is why I recommend that if you are planning on shooting at higher frame rates than 24 frames per second, to only shoot at them if you are planning on making the clip slow motion. Now, I know that there are people out there that say, oh man, you should shoot everything at 60 frames per second. It looks awesome. You can slow down anything that you want to in post. And that is true. But the issue that you're gonna run into is that as soon as you need to play back any of those 60 frames per second clips in real time on a 24 frames per second timeline, they're gonna look jittery, they're gonna look stuttery, and they're not gonna look as good as footage that you shot at 24 frames per second. So my recommendation to you, and this is what I follow as well, be very intentional with the frame rates that you shoot at. Do not shoot at 60 frames per second because, oh man, I might wanna slow something down. No, look at your shot, be decisive and say, I'm gonna want this in slow motion and post, I'm gonna shoot at 60. I do not want this to be in slow motion post, I'm gonna shoot this at 24. Be very intentional with that, because that way your footage is gonna look better because you made that decision in camera and you were not waiting till post to make a choice. One last thing that I'll say is do not add footage to a timeline where the timeline frame rate is higher than the footage frame rate. So if you have a timeline of 30 frames per second footage, do not put a 23.976 clip onto that timeline, because you're gonna deal with Premiere attempting to create magically out of thin air 6 frames, and it's gonna look really weird. Okay, great, Matt, you've rambled about frame rates for quite a while now, but my clips on my timeline are still not in slow motion. So can we finally cover how to do that? Yes, yes we can. You have a couple options here for how you wanna do that. Namely, you could right click on one of your clips on your timeline and go to speed slash duration. And for a 60 frames per second clip, you could set it to 40% speed, roughly. Hit okay, and we hit play. Hey, all right, that's in slow motion, that doesn't look bad. Or let's press Control Z or Command Z if you're on a Mac, and we'll go back and let's press the R key, which is going to bring up the rate stretch tool here. And I can click on the end of this clip and I can start to drag it out. That doesn't look bad, still slightly stuttery that way, but I have a better way to do things. You do not need to go through that. And this is my favorite way to make my clips slow motion. First, we're gonna go to here to the timeline, we're gonna select all the clips that we had already added, and we're going to press the delete key because we do not need those clips anymore. Second, I'm gonna go up here to the project window, and you're gonna see that I have my 3 clips here with the 3 separate frame rates. And what I first want you to know is that this is one of the first things that I do anytime I am editing a video in Premiere. So I go out and I shoot a big event, I import all the footage into Premiere, now I do this step. I'm gonna go to my first clip in my footage and I'm gonna select it. Then I'm gonna go to the last clip of my footage, I'm gonna hold down the shift key and I'm gonna click, and that is gonna select all of the clips. So imagine that there are hundreds of clips that I've shot, I want them all selected. Next, I'm going to right click on the name of any one of these clips, it does not matter, and that's gonna bring up this right click menu, and I'm gonna go down to Modify, Interpret Footage, and that's gonna bring up the Modify Clip dialog box. Next, I'm gonna go over here to Frame Rate, and as you can see, it currently says Use Frame Rate from File. Instead, we want to select Assume This Frame Rate, and we're gonna type in 23.976. So instead of Premiere reading the frame rates that every single individual video file is reporting that it has. Instead, it's gonna view all of the individual video clips as being at 23.976 frames per second. Next, we're gonna click OK. Now look over here at our frame rates. Instead of them being different, now they all say 23.976 frames per second. How cool is that? Now let's go and select one of these video clips. This is the one that was already 23.976 frames per second. So by changing those settings, it actually did nothing to it, and it's still playing back smoothly. We'll shorten that down a bit. Next, let's look over here at our 30 frames per second footage. I'm gonna drag this down the timeline. And as you can see, it is a little bit longer than it was before. It's a little imperceptible, but I'm gonna hit play on this here. Wait for me to get focus. And you can see that things are slightly slower. It feels just slightly different, and I'm a big fan of how that looks. Lastly, let's go over here to our 60 frames per second clip, and we're gonna drag that to the timeline. And as you can see, it got significantly longer. Look at that. So let's go here and hit play. And oh my gosh, look at that. It's so smooth. It looks incredible. I love the slow motion. Oh my gosh, it looks great. And we did not have to take a ton of steps to do it. It was just a few clips, and all of our clips were made slow motion. I absolutely love this technique for making slow motion footage. Makes my job and my life so much easier. To premiere, all of these clips are now 23.976 frames per second. So whereas I started with 24 and 30 and 60 frames per second clips, all of them to premiere are now the same and they look great. That's it. Thank you so much for watching. I hope this video has been helpful to you and given you some great insight into how to edit video clips that are varied frame rates. As I mentioned earlier, I have another video that details how I edit videos that have varied resolutions. So between these two videos, you should be pretty covered as far as resolution and frame rate go. Pretty excited about that. I will link to the resolution video up in the corner and down in the description of this video. I also have three other videos all about my export settings that I use whenever I'm exporting to YouTube, Vimeo, Facebook, or Instagram, and at different resolutions. So if you want to export at 4K or 1080 or Instagram resolution, because it actually has a resolution, I will link to those down in the description as well. As always, if you have any questions or comments, please feel free to leave one below or get in touch with me through my website, whoismatt.com. It is also a behemoth help to me if you would consider liking this video and subscribing if you want to see more videos like this in the future. I also have links down in the description of this video if you want to check them out. The link to my Instagram and my Facebook and how to sign up for one-on-one consulting with me and how to sign up for my newsletter and links to my wedding film production company. All of that is down in the description of this video. Thank you so much for watching and have a great day.